Today, I'm going to be cooking fish curry, or we call it curry ikan.
Okay, and what sort of key ingredients do you have for this?
Well, we got all these ingredients. I'm going to run through with you briefly. We got this ginger, garlic and onion, and we got this lovely curry powder.
I mean,
it is in a packet because I mean, when it comes to curries, it's very time consuming if you want to prepare it from scratch. See,
do you recommend this particular?
Yeah, this brand is the best one at Crossover. Well, it is available in most Chinese groceries, so you can easily get this. It comes in two types. I mean, this one is designed for the meat curry, and this one is for the fish curry. On top of that, we got this. Mixed herbs. There's like mustard seeds, there's a cumin, fenugreek as well. Yeah, there's a mix of herbs, and you can easily get this in an Asian groceries as well. Yeah, so that's the mixed herbs, and then we got this coconut milk, and also we got this tamarind, and we got fresh curry leaf as well, and we got okra and tomato to go with
it. Where would I get fresh curry leaves from?
You can get this in Asian groceries easily. Yeah, so that's all the ingredients. In terms of the fish, and I'm going to show you, I've got a selection of fish here. Right, we've got this red snapper, sea bream, we've got lovely sea bass, my favourite, and we've got catfish as well, and also mackerel. But the best one for this fish curry is the salmon.
Why is that?
Because I've tried it with other fish like monkfish or even with sea bass, but the flavour, I mean, somehow this salmon, and maybe this texture as well, and just bring out the flavour of the fish curry. I like to blend all the ingredients. I mean, like ginger, garlic, and onion. So,
and that's what I'm doing. Can you do that with a blender if I was making it at home?
Yes, you can. Yeah, what you can do is, I mean, you don't have to blend it separately. You can blend garlic, ginger, and onion together. Yeah. So.
And those are just normal onions.
Just normal onions. That's the thing about Malaysian food. I mean, some people think like it's so difficult to prepare, but in fact, I make it so easy. Like in my cookbook, I make it very simple for people to follow. So, so you need to blend this onion, and this is what I prepared earlier. That's how you blend it. You don't need to put any water in it. First, we start with the cooking oil, where we put about 8 tablespoons. I know, it's a lot there, but I mean, that's how we cook Malaysian food, but you can put less as well. So if you want to be authentic, I mean, the way we complement our curries, I mean, you can see the oil separate from the curry, okay? So that's ready now. It does, because I mean, when you fry onion, garlic and ginger, it's gonna start frying and then bring out all the aroma, okay? So start with the onion, so put 2 spoons. And I've got this ginger, only 1. Same with garlic as well, only 1. And just start frying this. And you're gonna smell all these combinations of this ingredients. Okay, so once you start smelling, I'm gonna put the mix up.
But you want? Like
seeds, they are because once you put in, I mean, in your curry, you're gonna bite it and you can taste all these spices. Only put 1/2 teaspoon because you don't want to put a lot of it, otherwise it's going to be a bit bitter. Yeah? And then put the fresh curry leaf as well. Going in.
And you can put every
curry. Yeah. You don't have to cut it. And then this is when you're going to smell all this fresh curry leaf.
Is it Asian?
Oh, you can get this in Asian groceries. Yeah. It's very, very, very convenient these days to get all these ingredients, okay? So that's ready now. I'm gonna put in the curry powder. We put 3 spoons of curry powder straight in. It is quite spicy because there's a chili powder in it. And then tamarind juice, got 4.
How do you get the juice? You just water down.
Yeah, just water. Just get a pinch of the tamarind block and then put a bit of water. But sometimes, I mean, it comes in a paste or sometimes in puree. But if you do that, just put like 1/2 spoons or so. Okay, and also a bit of water. That's going in. And then we're going to cook all these ingredients, and then you're going to see the oil start separate from all these ingredients. Put the fish in.
And And this is just normal salmon fillet.
Yeah, just a normal salmon fillet. The best if you get the skin off as well. And also, I'm gonna put in the coconut milk. So you don't have to put a lot of coconut milk. So about 4 spoons or so. You can use cod fish, but still, for me, it's not the best anyway. So you can use cod fish or you can use like mackerel or so. But mackerel's got very strong flavor to it. So that looks like it's ready now. So I'm gonna put in tomato. Okra.
Is that like those vegetables you can get in the supermarket?
It is, yeah. Well, in Malaysia, we call it lady finger because it looks like, well, lady's finger. So, yeah, again, this one you can get in the supermarket of, you know, Asian groceries as well.
And they're raw?
Yeah, no, they're raw. Yeah, everything is raw because with the vegetable, I prefer my vegetables to be crunchy and then you can still taste the sweetness of it as well. We cook this like every day and we eat this with the rice as well.
You could easily have this
Well, for us it's every day. So it's no question about that.